Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain microphone and its characteristic in this session. So basically, in this session, I'll discuss microphone and characteristics of microphone. And for that, here in this session, first I'll explain what is microphone. So basically, microphone, that is a transducer and that is converting sound signal into electrical signal, and that electrical signal is having same phase, same frequency and same amplitude as it is there with sound. So this is what the basic agenda which is there with microphone. And to understand microphone's characteristic, we have some basic parameters. So all those parameters that I'll be discussing in this session, where our basic agenda is to convert sound signal into electrical signal. So those basic parameters are sensitivity, SNR, frequency response, distortion, directivity and output impedance. So all those parameters that I'll discuss in detail in this session. Let us start with first characteristic, and that is sensitivity. Now see, what does it explain? Sensitivity means, it explains how weak sound signal can be detected by microphone. So sensitivity explains us how weak sound signal is being detected by microphone. It is defined as output of microphone in terms of millivoltage for a sound pressure in terms of 0.1 Pascal pressure at 1000 Hertz frequency. So if we give standard signal of 1000 Hertz frequency, how much electrical output in terms of millivoltage is generated? So that is been defined by sensitivity. So if it generates electrical signal for very weak signal, in that case, we can say our microphone is sensitive. So this is what one standard which is already predefined actually. So we usually check microphone with this signal 1000 Hertz of frequency, and with the pressure we try to check what is that millivoltage which is received as electrical signal by microphone. As a normal speech of sound is having pressure of 0.1 Pascal, sensitivity is having this criteria of pressure of 0.1 Pascal. However, some manufacturers quote sensitivity in terms of dBm. So they measures sound signal in terms of dBm. So that is what received signal in terms of millivoltage, dB millivoltage. So when you have voltage, let us say 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. So 10 log of 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. That is what dBm calculation. Now SNR. So some noise is generated in microphone due to resistance of the circuit and built-in transformer. So usually you will be finding in all electrical system there will be somewhat noise, and that is generated due to internal resistance of the circuit. It may be due to built-in transformer. So it is represented in terms of sound pressure level, SPL. So you will be finding that noise is been represented in terms of SPL. So instead of quoting noise alone, manufacturers quote signal to noise ratio. So we cannot even see, usually we need to see noise level with respect to signal, right? So instead of manufacturers shows this much noise is there, they show signal to noise ratio. So relative noise with respect to signal, that has been shown. So it is a ratio of dB output to output in absence of sound. Like see, here all we do is, we don't give any sound signal to microphone. But still, if it is converting noise as electrical signal,
right? So that is what unwanted signal, right? So which is what noise. So it is what a signal in terms of dB without any sound as input. So this is how we calculate noise. Frequency response. Now see, bandwidth of audio frequency in output of microphone within the plus or minus 1 dB of output. So that is what frequency response. So we usually see what is the bandwidth of audio frequency, and that bandwidth of audio frequency that should be within the range of plus or minus 1 dB response of output. So usually good microphone that is having frequency response which is flat over all audible frequency. So we have audible frequency range that is from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, and when you see response it should be flat. So that flat response is only considered as a bandwidth. So bandwidth of audio frequency within plus or minus 1 dB of output response is considered as frequency response. Other than that, frequency is not considered. So microphone which gives flat response within plus or minus 1 dB over frequency 40 to 15,000 hertz, that is considered as hi-fi audio system. So microphone which gives flat response with plus or minus 1 dB of amplitude for frequency of 40 hertz to 15,000 hertz is considered as good for hi-fi audio system. And for lower bandwidth like 80 hertz to 8000 hertz is acceptable for normal microphone, and even we can say it is for standard microphone, right? So in standard microphone or normal microphone we have bandwidth which is starting from 80 hertz to 8000 hertz. So this is what the frequency response which is there with acceptable normal microphone. But for hi-fi microphone, that frequency response should be from 40 hertz to 15,000 hertz with plus or minus 1 dB flat response. And there will be a limitation of lower and higher frequency, and that is because of mass of vibrating system and capacitance, right? So mass of vibrating system that is equivalent to inductance, and capacitance that is happening because of compliance, right? So if you see force to voltage analogy, so in that we know mass is equivalent to inductance, and capacitance spring constant K, that is equivalent to 1 by capacitance. So that mass means inductance and compliance means capacitance will attenuate higher frequency as well as lower frequencies. Like see, mass will attenuate higher frequency and compliance will attenuate lower frequency, as frequency omega that is equals to square root of k by m. So if you place values you will be finding how it attenuates frequency. You can see it over here. Also movable parts as natural resonance frequency, and this natural resonance frequency should be outside to the audible frequency range. So audible frequency range is 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So that natural resonance frequency that should be outside to the audible frequency range, and movable part may be resulting into noise which is there in audible frequency. So it sometimes you'll be finding when you tune your microphone, it generates some very weird noise sometimes, like toom, like that. Sometimes this kind of noise that is getting generated. So that is because of movable part of natural resonance frequency. And when you set it properly, that noise is getting eliminated. So frequency response in 40 hertz to 15,000 hertz is for hi-fi hi-fi audio system, and for standard microphone you will be finding that response should be from 80 hertz to 8000 hertz, and this frequency response is getting limited from lower frequency to higher frequency because of mass and compliance of spring, and that is actually attenuating higher frequency and lower frequency. Mass is attenuating higher frequency and compliance of spring is attenuating lower frequency, and that is limiting frequency response of microphone. Now you can see some frequency response of different microphone. All these microphone that I'll be explaining in future. So we will see all these microphone: carbon microphone, crystal microphone, condenser microphone, moving coil microphone, as well as ribbon microphone. So you can see its response, right? So all these microphones that we will be going to study in detail. So here I'm not discussing it. In future session, you'll be finding that in detail. Now distortion. So there are basically two types of distortion: non-linear distortion and phase distortion. Now in non-linear distortion, we can say it is created by distorted harmonics, and that generates distortion in amplitude. For quality microphone, that distortion should be less than 5%, and for hi-fi microphone, it should be there less than 1%. So non-linear distortion, that is generating distortion in amplitude, for quality microphone, means for standard microphone, that distortion should be less than 5%, and for hi-fi microphone, it should be lower than 1%. Phase distortion, so it happens when multiple microphone are used with different path of sound of sources. So when you use multiple microphone, it may generate phase distortion. So usually all we know is this distortion limit, that should be lower than 5% for quality microphone, and it should be less than 1% for hi-fi microphone. Now directivity. So directivity explains from which direction microphone receives signal. So it shows directional characteristic of sound reception by microphone. So from which direction microphone can receive signal, so that has been justified by directivity. Like, see, if I place microphone here, you can see I have placed it, and here with different angle you will be finding different signal is getting received. So this is what the pattern, and with respect to that pattern microphone is receiving sound. So this is what the radiation pattern, or one can say it, directional pattern of microphone. And mathematically we calculate that by E divided by E0, where E is actual maximum output of microphone. So that is there in this direction, so microphone is having actual output which is maximum in this direction, divided by E0, that is output of omnidirectional microphone. Now see, E0, that is output of omnidirectional microphone, and omnidirectional microphone receives equal signal from all the direction. So omnidirectional microphone is having this pattern which is circle. So omnidirectional microphone, that is even referred as pressure microphone. Bidirectional microphone, we will see, ribbon type microphone is bidirectional microphone. And cardioid microphone, so that is what series combination of pressure and ribbon microphone, so that will be cardioid microphone. Now you see omnidirectional microphone, here if you place mic, it is having radiation pattern which is circle, means it radiates, means it is having sound reception equal from all the direction. In bidirectional, from two direction you see its reception of sound is happening, so pattern of 8, that one can say. And in cardioid, if you combine these two, pressure and ribbon in series, then it will be having this type of pattern. If you add both of this, so it will make this cardioid, means its shape is heart shape microphone. So output impedance. So output impedance, it is used to determine which type of matching transformer would be needed to transfer power effectively from microphone to the transmission line and then to amplifier. So output impedance, that explains you by what impedance we need to have further circuit. And based on that further circuit, we can have a connection of further devices. So it should get matched perfectly. Impedance of the circuit and microphone should get matched to transfer maximum power. Now see, ideal microphone characteristic, let us discuss that. So ideal microphone should have extremely high sensitivity. It should have very high SNR. It should have flat frequency response over almost all audible frequency, which is from 20 Hz to 20 kilohertz. Natural resonance frequency should be outside of audible range. It should have minimum distortion. Correct output impedance should be there so that we can match it to the further circuit, and it should have required directivity. So this is what the ideal characteristic which is there with microphone. So this is all about characteristics of microphone. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions, and you will be finding all this material from my application. I have already uploaded all this material on my application. You can download it from there. And there are so many other engineering subjects which you can see it from my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.